Hi, and welcome to Stalking the Wild Autoharp 2017. This is the first edition for a new year, and I'm back in the saddle again, and I'm going to have to change my backdrop because this looks a little bit too much like a halo, and if you know me, you would agree. So we'll get on that in the next few weeks. In the meantime, today I am intending to open the huge can of worms called Selecting an Autoharp for Beginners. And this is a real dicey issue because the Autoharp is an instrument that a lot of people think, wow, now there's an instrument that I would be able to play. It looks really easy to pick up. And it is. Because you basically push a button and strum some chords, and you can take it further and further and further beyond that, but it has a very simple, basic beginning thing that you can get involved with as a beginner and be making music in a very short time. But, and this is a big but, getting one in your hands that's actually playable and enjoyable to play can be quite difficult. Because the factories don't make them fine-tuned well enough to be a really enjoyable experience. The chord bars, the buttons that are on the harps are not set up. They're set up and they rattle, and that you have to press down a long way on them, which means that your hands get fatigued very fast. And in order to avoid that, you have to take extra steps. Furthermore, if you buy a used one, say on eBay or down at the pawn shop, it might have felts that are falling off. Or most likely it has strings that are going to need to be changed very soon because they won't stay in tune because they're old. So for the beginner, there comes this long, big download of information that you have to wade through in order to know just what to get. And if you just go, well, I'll just get the cheapest thing and run down to the pawn shop or get one off of eBay, you'll be sorry. And have to do all this work either yourself or hire somebody else to do it, and there's nobody around in your hometown who knows how to do it. And so you end up sending it away and spending $100 just on shipping back and forth to get it to somebody who can fix it up for you. And you don't want that. So what you really want is somebody to tell you the different pros and cons of the different options that are out there. And I'm gonna try to keep this narrowed down to just the most general information and tell you where you can go to get more specific information. So I'm going to give you five levels of Autoharps, and they are going to descend in price from the most pricey down to the cheapest. And they're also going to descend from the most satisfaction in playing down to the least satisfaction in playing, okay? So with no further ado, here's my top five types of Autoharps to look at as a beginner, all right? And the first one is probably going to shock you. Item number one is luthier harps. A luthier harp is built by a private luthier in his or her shop, one at a time, by hand, but it's a precision instrument, and it is, the chord bars are finely made so that they don't rattle and they don't thump and they don't move a huge distance. This is a beautiful Autoharp by Pete Daigle. This is his TLC model. And the chord bars are nice and tight and they barely move. Okay? Which means that my hand, when I play, my hand does not get tired and fatigued by playing. And of course it comes with brand new pads and brand new strings and everything. So this is what I recommend first, because you not only get the harp, you get the experience of the luthier and his or her brilliance. in helping you to, you know, with any questions or concerns, or they can fine-tune it for you, all kinds of things like this, okay? But the luthier harp starts at about $900, okay? Which is sometimes a breaking point, you know, for a new beginner, and they want to start with something less expensive. Okay, so we're going to move down the list and look at some of the other options, okay? The next level that I would recommend, going down in price, but also going down a little bit in satisfaction, but barely, this is a really good option too, is a renovated vintage harp, okay? This is an auto harp that has been pre-used, sometimes a lot. The best vintage harps are from the 70s, some of them I think from the late 60s, 70s, maybe early 80s. They are typically Oscar Schmidt brand. They come off of eBay quite a bit. They come out of pawn shops. But the operative word here is renovated, which means that they've had one of these fellas, like a luthier or somebody who's really in the know about auto harps, kind of tweak it and upgrade it, and they tighten up the action on the chord bars for you and rearrange the chord bars into a more satisfactory arrangement for your hand, and they put new strings on it, things like this, okay? A renovated vintage harp can cost you $500, okay? Totally worth it, but you want to have it renovated by somebody who knows what they're doing, okay? And by the way, I'm going to put a list of names and websites, contact information for some of these guys in the notes below this video, okay? All right, now moving on. The next lowest step in price and in satisfaction is the upgraded new harp, okay? This is a new harp that has been upgraded, again, by somebody who does the renovations on the vintage harps, all right? They have taken a brand new harp, and they have tweaked it and adjusted the chord bars, and it generally doesn't need new strings because it's already got new strings on it, and it generally doesn't need new felt, and so you save that money, but you've still got somebody who's tweaking it and making it a little bit easier for your hand to work with, okay? And these usually start around $400 on up, okay? And again, in my notes, I'll give you links for people who will sell these. They will acquire them for you, and then they will renovate them and upgrade them, basically, into a very, very worthy and playable condition, okay? Brand new harps, they don't sound as good as the vintage ones, all right? The vintage ones have been hand-selected. Those of us who know what we're doing know what to look for in a vintage harp. The new harps are generally all built overseas, and they don't have the sound quality that they used to. It's unfortunate, but true, okay? And we know what we're talking about. So again, the satisfaction in playing these goes down a little bit, but the price also goes down. So it's just a matter of what you want to get into, all right? So that's level three. Level four, this is a new harp, as is out of the box, all right? This is the kind that you might buy off of Amazon, brand new, or you might find down at the music store, brand new. You might find it brand new off of eBay, great. $300 entry level for a Berkshire model Starburst 21 chord OS21C, usually about $300. But nobody has passed over it and done any extra work on it. So you're gonna get chord bars that rattle, and when you push them down, you have to push them down a good ways to get them to engage with the strings, and that causes hand fatigue. Okay. Also, it's going to be a new harp, so it's not going to sound as good as the old vintage ones. All right. But price comes down a little bit. $300 will get you into a harp like that, and you can basically tune it up and play it out of the box. It works, yes. But you might get a harp like this and then shortly on down the road choose to do the renovation work yourself. But you'll have to develop those skills in order to know what to do with that. And now level 5, okay? And this one has a big frown on the bottom because you don't really want to follow this option, and that is a used or vintage harp as is, okay? In other words, you order one off of eBay used, and what you get is what you get. And trust me, you don't want to take this option. All right. I've seen so many people. As a matter of fact, most people do this because this is where common sense says you would start. Well, just grab a used one off of eBay and it'll be great. Hey, the seller says it is in great shape. Well, they don't know. 99% of the people who are selling Autoharps online know nothing about them. They look at them, they don't see anything wrong, and so they go, hey, it's in great shape. But they don't know that underneath there's felts that are falling off because it's sat in a closet for 40 years or under somebody's bed. Or they don't know that those strings that are all out of tune aren't going to be able to be put back in tune for very long, because when they're old, they develop what's called string memory and they won't stay in tune and they sound really cruddy. And so you have to spend an extra couple hundred bucks on felt and strings, and you have to learn how to install them, okay? Or you can have all that done for you, but then you get into a level 2 harp, which is the vintage harp that's been renovated for you, you see. So this option is especially unsatisfying for the beginner because you get a harp that you can't play. And you thought, wow, I'm going to save all this money, and I'm going to get into an Autoharp that's really, you know, an instrument that's really easy to play, and I'm going to have fun with it right off. Not this way, you are. No. So that's why I'm doing this video. And the special kind that you want to avoid, the old black ones. All right? The old black ones are about half of what you see on eBay. All right? And yeah, they might look okay. And the seller might be saying they're okay. But the problem with the old black Autoharps was that they were built to be very light and very cheap. And you tune them up, and you've got a good chance that they're going to explode or collapse, that they can no longer take the stress of tuned strings. Or you tune them up and they don't for about 6 weeks or 6 months or a year, and then all of a sudden they collapse. And that can be really frustrating too, especially say you pay $100 and you get a black model Autoharp and you go, oh, well, the strings aren't very good and it's going to need new felt. So you go through all the rigmarole of getting new felt and strings on there. Either you send it off to somebody or you do the work yourself and you invest another couple of $100. And then you get it all tuned up and it collapses. And we can't know whether this is going to happen or not. It's a crapshoot, okay? So there is something wonderful about an old black Autoharp that has been renovated and it works good. It's light as a feather and it has this wonderful old-timey sound, yes, but you can't trust the seller and you can't trust yourself to know what you're going to get, and none of us, even who've been in the business, we look at things online like that all the time and we go, yeah, but might not work out for you. So my advice is just don't go there, okay? So those are my 5 levels of Autoharps. And you can go back through this video and you can take a look at those again. Again, they rank from the most expensive to the least expensive. There's a few other things that you're going to need to get started, all right? You're going to need a tuner, okay? An electronic tuner. All right, and they are not very expensive. One of the cheapest ones is this one. This is a Korg, a CA30. It's a chromatic tuner. It's all self-contained, and I think they run about $20. All right, and you have to make sure that your electronic tuner is a chromatic tuner because they also make them for guitars, and those only read the 6 notes that are on guitar strings. Okay, so get a chromatic tuner, and you're going to need a tuning wrench. Sometimes the harp comes with it, all right? And they're either shaped like an L or a T, It's great if you can get one that has a hole in it that looks like a star instead of a square. All right, the square works too, but if you can get a star, even better. And some harps have fine tuners on them. The more expensive ones have fine tuners on them, where you tune with an Allen wrench down at the bottom as well. And those are brilliant. But those are going to run the price of the harp up by a couple $100. Okay, so you need to know that. Something else you should know is Oscar Schmidt harps, which is sort of the industry leader, come in A models and B models. All right, all of the new contemporary auto harps are B models, except for the one that's called the reissue. All right, and it's black, but it's a new harp. It's something that is modeled on harps of the past, and it has a real pretty graphic on the front. The reissue is an A model harp. The difference being, and I don't have an A model harp here that I can show you, the strings at the non-tuning end, there's the end that goes to the tuning wrench, and the pins that you turn to tune the strings. At the other end, at the anchor end, on an A model, they wrap around the bottom of the harp and they mount on pins. Okay, through a little grommet in the string. Okay, the grommet sits on a pin, and it wraps at 90 degrees around the end of the harp. All right. Usually, all that's under a cover, and you can't see it. All right. The B models are mounted in a groove, and there is a pin instead of a bridge. All right. The pin, the harp passes around the pin, and then goes to the tuning pin that you turn. Those are the B model harps, okay? And it's pretty easy to see. Just Google A model harp, B model harp. You'll see the difference in what those are, okay? Most of the Oscar Schmidts are B models, all right? And also, you probably want a 21 chord auto harp, especially an Oscar Schmidt 21 chord auto harp, all right? The reason I recommend this is that it's easy to rearrange the chord bars into other arrangements, and there are better arrangements than what come on the harp. You rearrange them and it's more ergonomic for your fingers, okay? But if the buttons don't shift on the chord bars, I know this is a little technical, you can't move them to other rows, okay? An Oscar Schmidt 21 chord auto harp has a black plastic cover that covers all the chord bars so that you can't see them. It's maybe not as attractive as the exposed chord bars, but it allows you to shift the buttons around. And you want to be able to do that, especially when you're a beginner, so that you can find an arrangement that is more satisfying for you to use personally, okay? So you want a 21 chord auto harp to start with, preferably an Oscar Schmidt 21 chord, a tuner, and a wrench, okay? What about a strap? A lot of beginners want to know about straps. It's so that you can stand up while you play. If you want to play with a strap, yes, you're going to need a strap and you're going to need strap buttons, all right? So I'm going to show you where they commonly go. If you're going to hold a harp up like this, there's two strap buttons. Usually one goes right out here on this corner of the harp. Sometimes you'll see it around the end up here. One goes there, and the other one is down here on this side. All right, there it's on the side rail. Sometimes it's around on the front. Some people will tell you one is better than the other. If they're on the sides of the harp like this, they can dig into the case. And you need to know that, okay? Some cases it matters, sometimes it doesn't. If you have a cardboard case and this on the side, then it's gonna dig a hole in the side of your case eventually. All right, so put them around on the front. If it's around on the front though, sometimes the strap can touch this bass string here and cause problems, all right? And there's different kinds of straps, I know, and I'm not gonna get into all of that in this video, okay? Also, a case is a good idea for an auto harp. And cases run the gamut from a I don't know, like a $20 or $30 case up to a $300 case. And again, that falls outside of what I'm going to go into in this video. But there you have it. Five different hierarchies of Autoharps, all right, to consider, and all that you need to know, all right. You can contact me with questions about choosing a new Autoharp or one of the guys that is listed down in the notes to this. I have luthiers. I have guys who don't luthal. They don't build Autoharps, but they fix them up for you, or they can tell you how to fix them up, and they're a good resource. Maybe you're near one of them and you can actually go to them in person. And they can help you. So I have links to all of that. I teach lessons online. You should know that. I have a good number of students who are studying with me privately, and I also publish tutorials here on YouTube, and so you can watch for those. There's already about 25 of them, I think, 30, going into the different techniques of playing the Autoharp, and I'll be getting back to those very soon. And thank you for tuning in to Stalking the Wild Autoharp. I'm Hal Weeks. My website is halweeks.com, and you can find out about my online lessons there. And until next time, thanks for watching Stalking the Wild Autoharp, and I'll see you next time. Bye-bye.